What I'm going to focus on, if you could, what I'm going to focus on really is three things. Firstly, to look at some definitions, because we bandy these words around, commissioning is a big buzzword at the moment, everything's commissioning, and I'm not sure that more than 3.5% of the people who are using the word commissioning actually know what commissioning means. So I'm going to give you some definitions, what commissioning is, what tendering is, and what procurement is, because there is a difference. And I'll talk a little bit about the general meaning of commissioning, but then I'll talk a little bit about the very specific meaning of what the word commission means when you are talking to a commissioner in a local authority, because it means something very different from what we would commonly use the term commissioning to mean. So those are some definitions. Then I'm going to talk, really importantly, again this goes back to the definition, I'm going to talk about the strategic importance of commissioning. And this shouldn't mean anything to you now, but it will mean everything to you by the time I finish, and you will understand what that means and why commissioning is very, very important strategically for your organisation and the communities that you serve. And finally, we're going to look at the risks. What are the risks to your organisation? Matt has talked about what you need in place in your organisation to be seriously a contender for a contract. I'm going to talk about some of the stuff that's great. You get to the point of getting the contract, or you get to the point of looking at getting the contract, but actually, what are the risks to your organisation if you get that contract? Because winning the contract isn't everything. You can win the contract and you can lose a hell of a lot of money. And Matt's got some experience on that as well. So it's possible to be successful and lose it. So we'll talk a bit about that as well. And I'm going to end with something, which I'll leave at the end. So if we move on. So commissioning. What is commissioning? So here's the definition. This is the definition of commissioning. Commissioning is the cycle of assessing the needs of people in an area and designing and then securing an appropriate service to meet those needs. What? What does that mean? So let's move on. So what does that mean? This means commissioning is a process that a public body, usually local authority, we'll talk about other bodies that commission, the public body goes to identify the services that it's going to deliver. Now, every single public body, be it a local authority, be it a PCT, be it the NHS, be it the government, right, has a legal duty to go through the process. They don't just sit in their offices and say, well, we're going to need a means and wheels service, we're going to have some stuff for refugees, we're going to give some grants for this, we're going to have some schools, we're going to have some aftercare. That's what they do, but actually, legally, they should go through the process of looking at their entire community that they exist to serve and saying, what are the needs that are out there? Let's look at all the needs, then look at what we want to deliver and what services we need to design to meet those needs, and then they set their priorities. And they want to set the priorities of the services that they want to deliver to you, that you're paying for, through your taxes and through your council tax. They then have got to decide, how are we going to deliver those services? We decided that we want schools, we decided we want a peace force, we decided we want meals on wheels, we decided we want some refugee community organizations, we decided we want some charities. We decided we want all these things, right? How are we actually going to deliver those services? Are we going to do it ourselves? So is everything going to be delivered by council workers? Or are we going to have everything delivered by private companies? Or are we going to have everything delivered by charities? Or are we going to have a mix? Who's best placed to deliver each of these services? And they technically, legally have got to go through the process of thinking, is there anyone else out there who can do this better than us? That's what commissioning is. Commissioning isn't just a bit of the stuff that Matt was talking about before, the contract. That's contracting. Commissioning is a process of sitting down strategically and planning everything that gets delivered by the local authority in the area where you live. And they should be involving you in the process of deciding what those services are. And questioning themselves, is there an organisation out there that can do this better than us? Is there somebody else out there that can actually do this better than council? Could that organisation be you? So that's what commissioning is. Procurement, when we talk about these words of commissioning, procurement, tendering, they all get banged on. Procurement is the actual process. So after they've set down and gone, worked out what they're going to deliver, they've then got to go out and buy it. And that's what procurement is. Procurement is the actual purchasing of the service provided by a charity, a social enterprise, a business, or a public agent. So that's what procurement is. It involves tendering, which is the other big buzzword you hear about. So it involves tendering to deliver what it's decided it wants to deliver. And then we get to what is tendering. So tendering is the actual process of the stuff that Max is talking about. Tendering is a bit where you bid for the contract. Tendering is when the contract comes out, it gets advertised wherever these things get advertised, and then contract comes out and you write your spec. You tell why you think your organization is best to deliver against that contract. And that's what tendering is. Right? So let's go back to commissioning. Commissioning involves, firstly, it's a cipher. It involves an assessment or a reassessment of needs. So it isn't just the initial assessment. Every year they should go through that cycle. Let's look at the needs again. What needs are out there in our community? So assess the needs, identify what resources they have available. So the council thinks about, well, we've got a budget of £785 million to deliver all the services, so everything we need to deliver has got to be delivered for £785 million. We'd love to deliver quite as much as that, but we've only got, so that's the resources. Next. Plan how to use the resources. So this budget, divide up your budget, we're going to spend £200 million on education and whatever else. And then arranging the service delivery through a procurement process. So the bit that you're not going to do yourself as a local authority, you decide, well, we're going to get either private companies or charities or public or whatever else to deliver these services for us. Yep. And then monitoring and delivering service. So that's the process. And we'll wrap it through this because we've done that. Right. So who commissions? Public bodies, local authorities, DCT, the NHS. Important, the really important thing is commissioning is a strategic process. Remember what I said at the beginning, commissioning isn't just a contract, commissioning is the actual working out what contract you're going to deliver. Your organisation should be involved, no matter how small you are, no matter whether you've got no staff and there's only two volunteers, you should be striving to be part of the commissioning process. Because even if you never intend to tender for a contract, even if you never intend to be involved in actually getting the money, because you serve a community, you want your community's needs to be taken into account when the services that the local authority that you area you live in get designed. So you should be in there talking to the commissioner saying, well, our community needs, these are things our community needs. I never want a big group, I don't want to be part of the contracting office because we couldn't deal with it. But I'm telling you that what our community needs is this, 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 and this, and you better make sure that you are designing that into the contract that you design. So you should need the commission involved at that level. Next. There are risks to commissioning, and the rapid to these. If you decide that you want to get involved in tendering, if you decide your organization has got all the factors that Max talked about, and you've done the risk analysis, and you've done the assessment, you've got the business plan, you've got all the things in place, you need to have in place to be even considered, and to be honest, for most organizations, that you probably are in a state, you probably won't be there yet, probably got a long way to go. But if you think you are, you have to think there are other risks. There are internal organizational risks you've got to think about. Financial governance, service related, and reputational. I'm going to quickly run through what those might be. Financial ones are just underfunding, and again, Max will tell you all about this. You get a dodgy contract, you think it's fantastic, and you actually end up spending more money delivering the contract than you get from the contractor, so you lose money on the contract. That's straightforward. Late funding, payment in arrears, has a problem with cash flow, massive problems with lots of organizations, particularly small ones. Funding is linked to quality of service, which isn't very often the case when you put in for a grant. You get the money for the grant, and you deliver what you deliver, and that's fine. You know, you don't come back and ask the money back off you. If you get involved in a service contract, you will ask for the money back. If you don't deliver against your target, they'll say, right, if you only deliver 50% of the target, they'll say, right, give 50% of the money back. So there's lots of risks involved financially in getting involved in contracting. Next, governance risk. It's very easy to lose sight of the ball. You exist to serve your community, not to run services. If running services is part of serving your community, that's great. But it's very easy to go off down blind alleys and become involved in lots of big contracts and actually lose sight of the purpose of your object and what you exist to do. And also, lots of independence is the other one. It's very easy to get trapped into the cycle where you're no longer an independent organisation. We move on. I won't go into service related risk. The big one is obviously reputational risk. If you get involved, it's just about losing your identity and losing your separateness. it's very easy for people to point a finger at you and say, hold on a minute, how can you claim to be independent if all your funding comes from the local authority? How can you claim to be independent if all your funding comes from the home office? You claim to be serving, but you know, surely you can't speak out against it. The local authority does something that's against the interests of the community that you serve, but you are in the pay of that local authority. How can you speak out against them without risking your... So there are risks there. And obviously, if you don't deliver against it, it can harm your reputation as a charity as well. So you need to bear that in mind. Move on. I won't bother with that. The final thing to say, I just reiterate, commissioning is an overall process. If you never intended to be for a contract, you should still be involved. You should speak to the commissioners and tell them what your community needs. The final thing I'll leave you with is this. Commissioning is becoming more and more prevalent. It's becoming more and more prevalent because councils, local authorities are moving away, or supposedly have talked in the past about moving away from grants because they felt the grants were inappropriate. They felt the grants were inappropriate because there was a feeling that there was improper relationship, that things weren't open, that the processes weren't open for scrutiny, and then actually what was happening was that your a commissioner or a grant giver had an easy relationship with a local organisation that they knew and understood, so therefore they just get the money to them. So the idea is that commission is actually a much more open process, of course, it's a much fairer process. Absolute rubbish. Commissioning is much less fair and much less open than any grant giving process has ever been. But you can use that to your advantage, because the reality is commissioners are lazy. Just like everybody else in the world, they will find the easiest way to achieve their ends. And if that means, if they know that your organisation exists, and if they know that you're delivering services in your area, and they know about you, and you talk to them, and you batter the door down, and you phone them, and you speak to them, at the end of the day, they say, well, we want to deliver this. Who do you know who's doing that kind of work? Oh, I know. Yeah, that organisation. I'll pick up the phone, and I'll phone up to them. Hey, I've done that. I'm thinking of... Because you've got your name in there, because they know about you, they will come and they will seek you up. And that's why it's really, really important to develop those personal relationships with commissioners. To have that personal relationship, because you will be the first person that they think about when they think about the service that they're planning to deliver. They think about you and they'll come to you and they'll say, could you possibly do this for us? And you want to be on that end. So I say, develop, it's really, really important. Develop, find out who the commissioners are, and then mind them, bug them, annoy them until they give you the service.